What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Negoose. So the full swamp creature granny cosmetic is finally here. And I don't know if you remember, but I posted a YouTube community post about 2 weeks ago asking you guys the ability of an actual swamp creature, right? And the reason why I asked this is because I wanted to create a build that is specifically tailored to a swamp creature's ability. The build that I'm gonna be bringing in is gonna be the Lost in the Swamp build. So the main point of this build is to curse survivors so it's hard for them to find their teammates, and the longer it takes for them to find their teammates is the more chaos we are gonna cause. So for the first perk, we got Monitor and Abuse. So swamp creatures have really good stealth and really good eyesight as well. So Monitor is going to decrease our terror radius by 8 meters while we're not in chase. Monitor also gives you an extra 10 degree field of view. For the next perk, we got Hex the Third Seal. And this is the most important perk for this build. What this perk does is when we injure a survivor, they're going to suffer from the blindness status effect. So this means no aura reading for them at all. If they have any perks or add-ons that will be able to make them see the killer or their teammates in any way, they won't be able to see them. This also applies to survivors when they are hooked. For the next perk, we got Hex Undying. This is just there to make your Hex the Third Seal stay up longer. So when our Hex the Third Seal does get cleansed, it'll transfer over to a next dull totem. For the last perk, we got Scourge Hook Monstrous Shrine, and this is also a really important perk in this build. What it does is it transforms all 4 hooks in the basement to Scourge Hooks. Also, you get 4 random hooks that transform into Scourge Hooks around the map. If we hook a survivor on any of these Scourge Hooks and we are 24 meters away, the hook is gonna grant 20% faster entity progression on that survivor. This can lead to survivors going into second stage or dying on hook really, really quickly, especially if survivors are blind from third seal. I've noticed with this perk as well, it makes survivors rush the hooks even if they're injured, because they don't want their teammates going in second stage or dying on hook. And that can lead to some grabs. It can lead to easy downs if you have a whole lot of traps set up. All right, so that's it for the perks. Let's get into the add-ons. And for the first add-on, we got the good old Rusty Shackles. So whenever a survivor triggers their trap, they're not gonna get a notification. They're never gonna know. We could teleport and hit them. Sometimes I will put traps near generators and can get grabs on survivors sometimes. So this adds another stealth factor to this build as well. And for the last add-on, we got the Dried Cicada. This is just going to increase the distance from where we could teleport on the map, giving us better map control on the swamp. And it wouldn't be a full swamp creature build without the granny's cookbook offering. We are going to be sent to the backwater swamp, and there are some really good benefits when we play in our habitat. A major benefit to this map is that you can get some really good hex totem spots. Sometimes you will get hex totems in every corner of the map, and it could be quite difficult for survivors to find them. And your traps blend in fairly well in the mud. So this build obviously gets destroyed by Swift, because if they are on comms, they could just communicate and tell each other where they are. Also, losing your hex totems fairly early can suck as well. But overall, really fun build. I got some gameplay showcasing how the build works. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. Let's get into the gameplay. We are on the Grim Pantry with the granny. Alrighty, we spawn at shack and we got basement here. Good to know. All right, so this new cosmetic looks absolutely amazing, man. The arm and everything is just... Let's look at the arm, bro. That looks so good. Okay, we got... our hex totems aren't in the best spot, sadly. We know someone's on that gen. Let's trap our totems. So if they do try to cleanse them, we could teleport. Okay, so they're all in the area. Nice! Monitor allowed me to get in real close there and get a hit on Kate. She's running the shack. Beautiful, man. Sadly, though, we don't have the other teammates cursed by third seal. But just having basement hook here is huge. Having basement is huge. Especially with Monster Shrine. So I gotta get 24 meters away from the basement for Monster Shrine to do its work. And now all the survivors are gonna have to pretty much just rush the basement before this Kate goes in second stage. Someone's on this. Monitor's just letting me get in, bro. It's just giving me free injuries, bro. God damn. All right. So yeah, Nancy's now cursed by the third seal. See if we can get this Leon cursed as well. He's gonna throw that. Yeah, let's go around. I want to push him to shack side. Someone's rushing to basement here. Nice. Yo, that's huge. Yeah, Leon was desperately rushing down here to get her before she went a second. Okay, let's break that. Person ended up dying on hook. Oh my god. So the yeah, they're on gens while their people were in the basement. And we're keeping the Leon occupied here, so that person's about to go in second in basement. I'm gonna drop Leon and head over there right now. Monster Shrine is like literally crippling them right now. Getting a hook state is huge, man. Oh, I had no traps up there. All right. Rinse, repeat. So as you can see, that one Kate in the beginning just destroyed her team, man. All right. We got a good amount of traps in the area. Let's leave and let Monster Shrine do its work. We could keep this Leon here occupied. So the other Leon is injured. He has to go to basement to make a play. He has to make it snappy because the time is ticking with Monster Shrine. She's about to go in second stage. There it is. Okay, someone's over there. The last Leon. Good to know. Up you go. He's probably rushing to the basement right now. She died in basement. Oh my god, bro. That's insane. GG's. We are on the Grim Pantry with the granny. Bro, you see that hex totem in the corner? Oh my god. We do have one like in the middle. But that one in the corner is gonna be clutch. I heard crows, so they're at the main building. Every time you hear a crow on this map, like if you hear the crows go off, that means the survivors are in the main building. So we're using our habitat to give us info right now. They're all running to this main building area. So you know what? Gonna get a couple traps here. All right. He's cursed as well. So we got Zarina and Felix blind. They won't be able to see auras right now. Undying, he's over here. We're getting in real close right now. Nice, we got in close to Monitor before it was actually able to run away and get more distance. Beautiful. Up you go. Alrighty, let's get out the area. So Monster Shrine could do its work. He's killing himself on hook. Don't think he's too happy. This girl really wants my totem. Let's reset that trap. I wanted to hit the Rebecca. Alright, she's cursed as well. Oh my freaking goodness. Alright, Shiva's in the area. Yeah. Nice. So we got the whole team cursed. We got our 4 stacks of third seal. So now they won't be able to see any auras at all. Survivors do see the bubble of where the survivor gets hooked. But they gotta be paying attention for that. Some of them don't. They're healing up fairly quickly, actually. Yeah. I'm pretty sure all 3 of them were grouped up healing. Alright. Nice. We're keeping everyone occupied while that girl on the hook is about to go in second stage. Okay, they're on my totem. That's fine. Beautiful. That survivor is gonna go on second stage. All right, there's an unhook. That's good. We did her damage already. She lost a hook state. So she's on death hook now. All right. Someone's rushing the hook here. She's trying to she's trying to burn my trap, but she couldn't see it, bro. Benefit with this map is that your traps blend in really, really well. So it's hard for them to see it and burn it. So I'm assuming they're all trying to heal right now. Or maybe they can't even see each other's auras. There's a boon, yeah. They're trying to reset somewhere. The Rebecca killed herself on hook. Oh my god. Okay. Let's trap the window. I want to push her to where I have those traps back there. Let's trap the pallet now. Hopefully, yeah, she's running there. Perfect. She is running where I want her. Wow, perfect dead hard, bro. Usually it's like hard for someone to react to rusty shackles with dead hard, but she did that. It's well played. I'm gonna have to drop her. Yeah, these guys are on 2 gents. They're somewhere back here. All right. Gonna, yeah, he's a long gone. Let's get some traps here, so if he does come back, we could teleport and hit him. Hopefully. Hello? Wow, that could have been a grab, bro. He wasn't even aware of that one. Actually screwed that up. Someone's back there at the generator. I hear him on this side. Nice. We cut him off here. Perfect. I literally heard his team. Maybe they could have had more progress if that guy... Yeah, didn't rage quit on first hook. Or rage on first hook, I should say. Someone's here, bro. Yeah, I have no idea where they are. Head on. Into flashbang. Oh, I think they're doing the stun challenge. Yeah. That was like the hardest challenge for me to do on this Halloween event. Where the hell? This girl's gone, bro. And she's back on the gen. Lock her again. She wants her stun. Alright, good. Okay, we know where the last person is. Awesome. They're maybe gonna run to main building, I assume. Up you go. I hear crying. She's in the locker. Grim Pantry again, bro. Damn. I remember seeing, like, there was, like, a bug with the Pale Rose main building where you weren't able to, like, vault the window there. So, I'm assuming they took it out. Because I keep getting Grim Pantry. The middle is so open. Damn. Really, really quiet, bro. Honestly, I don't even know why I'm setting up here, because the majority of the gens are on the shack side. I did spawn here, but since there's no one, like, here yet, let's just set up here. Yeah, really quiet. I think they spawn on the main building side. Okay, they're on that. No one's on that. Let's just head over here, see if we could, like, force them to the traps that we placed. Are they gonna commit and give me some free hits? Nice, okay. Alright. Ashes cursed, beautiful. And yeah, we are going up against a two-man here. The Dark Eye and Light Eye are a Swift, so this should be interesting to see how this build would work against a Swift. I think the other two are solo queues, so shouldn't be a problem. If it was a four-man Swift, then I'll be worrying. Okay. Curse the Jill. He thought I was gonna break the pallet, bro. He was waiting for that flashlight blind. And my guy, like, just jumped down the stairs. Okay, so Fang and David are going to the main building to reset. Yeah, they're gonna keep running to the main building. So we know three people are in this area, so you know what? Let's see if we could just intercept them from resetting. You don't want that. Okay. If we could push them to our side, that's good. Fang is playing the main building. I'm gonna have to drop her. Oh, beautiful. David's going to where we want him to. This is perfect. What's good is we have everyone blind. He didn't even know we're coming, bro. Someone's on this. The Jill. I hear David. Oh, he's waiting for a flashlight save. He dead-hearted really, really early there, bro. Alright, let's get him up. Beautiful, beautiful. Good pressure. So the Ash and the Fang are gonna have to reset in order to do anything here. Alright. So we got the two, we got the Swift on hooks. So they won't be able to communicate with the other two. Right? I should chase David here. We know he has dead heart, so we're gonna have to wait it out. There it is. And we got a Scorch Hook right there on the hill. Alright, so Dark Eye got unhooked. So I'm assuming they're gonna go for the other person, right? It's your Swift buddy. They're about to go in second stage. Wow! Light Eye went into second. Wait, the Fang's here. I don't know if they're on comms. Cause that hook was right beside the Fang. Interesting. There's Ash. We caught him here with monitor. Nice. Okay. Jill's here. She is speeding to that hook. Ah, see? Calm communication right there. As you can see, the Jill went around. I had a trap on the left there. And the Jill went around it. So they are on comms, but I don't know how they screwed up earlier. Here, crying. Fang is here. She just smashed a pumpkin. She's down here somewhere. There you are. You got her. I'm pretty sure they were lost in the swamp, bro. They had to be. For one of the hooks, I was for sure. The traps couldn't see. No chance. And the radius was so tiny. See? Perfect swamp creature hag build, man. GG's.